Hey and welcome to Ahrefs monthly product updates. We have two tool updates, one cross-tool update, and two general updates to share today. Let's start with Site Explorer. We've made two updates here. First up, we've added a new widget in Overview 2.0 that shows you important metrics for backlinks and referring domains. Use this to get a sense for the distribution of followed, nofollow, UGC, and sponsored links for your target. You can also see the distribution of your target's backlinks by URL rating or by domain rating. Moving on, we've launched three outgoing links reports: Link Domains 2.0, Outgoing Anchors 2.0, and Outgoing Links, which is a brand new report. Here are some highlights. First, Link Domains 2.0. This report shows you a list of the unique domains that your target is linking to. Newly added in this report is this linked pages column. And if you click on the number in the linked page column for HubSpot's domain, for example, you see we've linked to all of these pages this many times. We've also added a bunch of new filters which you can use to quickly sift through data. For example, set the DR filter to a maximum of 10 to see which low authority websites you link to. Moving on to Outgoing Anchors 2.0. This report shows you the terms and phrases used in anchor texts for the outgoing links from your target website. We've added new filters here as well. You can now do things like add a filter for outgoing anchors by referring page language to look at only German anchors used on the site. Or you can add a filter for linked domain name and type in a URL to see which anchors are pointing to that specific website. Let's move on to the new outgoing links report. This report shows you all the external outgoing links on your target. Like in the previous two reports, we've added a bunch of useful filters to help you zoom in on data. Take this target DR filter for example. You can set it to 0 to 20 to see all the outgoing links on your website that are pointing to low authority domains. Let's move on to Rank Tracker. We have one small update here. We've renamed the term Visibility to Share of Voice. Share of Voice is a term that's more commonly used in the SEO and marketing worlds. It represents a website's overall visibility in organic search results for the keywords being tracked. Next up, we have one cross-tool update. If you look at the SERP overview widget in Site Explorer or Keywords Explorer, you'll see a new traffic value metric right here. This value is country-specific, like the traffic and keywords metrics. On to our general updates, which are both for enterprise plans. First up, we've added a new user role called Guest. Unlike other users, guests cannot create new projects and only have access to projects and folders that are explicitly shared with them. This is perfect for controlling user access in the workspace. I'll leave a link to more information on user control features below. Moving on to our last update, we've added two powerful single sign-on or SSO features. First, you can now enable SSO-only login for the workspace. This means that workspace members cannot use other authentication methods besides SSO to log into Ahrefs. The exceptions are the workspace owner and admins, who'll be able to log in using their email and password in the case of SSO failure. Second, you can now enable SEIM to make it easier for your organization's admins to manage user access across multiple applications. What SEIM does is allow a third-party identity provider, or IDP, to manage users within the Ahrefs workspace. Once SEIM is enabled, any user assigned to the Ahrefs application in the IDP will automatically be added to your Ahrefs workspace. So, as long as a user isn't assigned to Ahrefs in the IDP, they'll be removed from the workspace. Please reach out to our support team for help with enabling SEIM for your IDP. And that's all for today. If you have any feature requests, you can leave them in our canny, linked in the description below. See you in the next update and have a great day.